here, just going around the room, doing a quick round robin, talking about that one thing that kind of stuck out overall with the film.
My bad, I was late. I didn't know it was going to start on actual time.
Yeah, we try to
do that,
right?
No, what I took from the movie is just the way I like if you notice in that movie, not one time did they refer to anybody or themselves as black people. Right. They say black people one time.
Right.
And they made one off kilter joke about, oh, I've had a picture of the broken white boy. But that was really just a tie into another character in Marvel. So it's, even that was just a tie in. So I always look at race as a microcosm of just the world, period. It's just a social construct used to divide. And so it was more than just like a black movie. And that's the part that like I think people miss is it wasn't a black movie. It wasn't like a black movie.
Exactly.
The cast was all people that looked like us, but it was more about culture. And so like you have everybody on social media and everybody going back and forth about, oh, why you guys wearing the sheepies and why you doing? Because it was a culture, like even like researching like all the different like the guy with the lip plate, that's based on actual culture in the countries that surround that area. So each one of the different cultures that were incorporated into the tribes was based on actual culture. Even the language they're speaking was based on the actual African language. Mm-hmm. It wasn't like where, you know, sometimes in these kind of movies they create a language.
Right.
Which is pretty cool. But anyway, it was based on like a culture thing that had nothing to do with race or anything, any social construct. It was like the fact that they had they had been tapped by the outside world at all. They didn't even have those chains of a social construct. They only knew tradition.
Mm-hmm.
Even to the point where it's like, hey man, we don't even like this dude. He's like, well, you're the king, I gotta, it's tradition.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, even to the point, and it's so many things about you that I like, so I'm gonna try to like keep it brief. But I was brief. Okay. but I just like how dope the women were in this movie. That was my favorite part.
If you had been on time, you would have heard that in the beginning.
Not black women to be on time after 400 years.
What's the main theme of?
Yeah, you guys must want, what was your theme? What was your?
My main theme was balance.
Oh, balance. Look at that.
That was my main theme, like balance.
Exactly. You want to say?
Just like literally the men and the women were just like, it was like equal, even kind of like kind of cheap music, because it's like it was like an understanding, like it was nothing.
It was like one functional.
Yeah, yeah. It wasn't like I bow to you or you bow to me. Like it wasn't like submit. I hear people say submit. It wasn't even submit. It's just a balance, like a chain on a bicycle.
Cause you see the leader sitting there, and then the woman speaking for the leader. The person speaking was a woman, or vice versa, when they were speaking to the king. So you'd always see balance. You no matter what, or they have a fighting scene and. When Killmonger brought his army, it was a whole bunch of men.
Right.
T'Challa came up, he had a whole army of women.
Right.
So it's always balance. It's just, so there wasn't women are the weaker sex or men are the stronger sex. Like I said, I think we as a culture have made that divide between women and men. I don't think a woman should have a problem being that person behind the king, because if you know your role, you know that you're really that strength from him.
Right.
If you really know what your role is. And I hate to say it that way, but Brian Mack, the priest of our house. But if I don't play my part, the house when he was able to fly all over the world and do what he needed to do when he left Wakanda. So it's like you said, balance.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Well, the one thing for me, I have been accused on a number of occasions when I'm talking to a room full of women and I'm trying to guide us in conversation so that we can be accountable for change, whatever that is. Discomfort normally takes place, so I get accused from time to time of being a little hard on women. Mm-hmm. Finally, somebody made a movie that showed melanated women the way I see them every day. I see them that way every day. They don't see themselves that way every day, but I see them that way every day. So now a film comes out and now they're like, okay, yeah, look how beautiful and magnificent we are. Look at our strengths. But all of those women in that film were women who were responsible and accountable in everything that they said and everything that they did. That was their beauty, that was their strength. So overall, for me, that was, I love that part. Okay, this is my favorite, I've been waiting to ask this question. What was your favorite line in the movie?
You made me, I can do that one first.
your favorite line or your favorite?
I got one.
We had the same one, so.
Oh, okay. My favorite, well,
I wrote that thing down. Mine was, if I had to pick one, I mean, the whole movie was perfect.
Right.
But at the end, when T'Challa was speaking to the United Nations or whatever, and he said, much more connects us than separates us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And that is just so important for people, because right now we're in a good place as a society. We're in a very volatile place, but that just means that the truth is coming to the light. It's like a process.
Right.
So there's a quote unquote, you know, the racial tension. People are saying, oh, this is building up, it's becoming an us versus them thing, and
right,
all of that, which I don't get involved in that.
Right.
And regardless of the cast and that it was predominantly melanated people of color, and at the end there was still an influence of someone who was considered to be an outsider.
Right.
But that went to the edge of all that he could to give what he had, even took a bullet for the sister at the drop of a dime, you know?
Right.
That helped to bridge the gap in Wakanda's mind. About certain people,
right,
immediately want to say a colonizer.
Right.
Maybe, okay, we know what goes on, but everybody, you know, that man was all heart.
Right.
And when he said much more connects us than separates us, that, you know, that's my motto.
Okay.
We're all one thing, whether you know it or not.
Right.
So,
right.
I really love that.
Go ahead, Shane.
Hey, Auntie.
Hey, Auntie. That is definitely my favorite line in the movie. I mean, it was pure. It was pure. It was like, wow. It for me, that was the line that set the tone for who they were getting ready to deal with.
Yeah, exactly.
Ooh, mm-mm.
That was the one, you know. Even though he had did the, when he told little girl, he said in the museum. He said, I'm going to take it off your hand. I'm going to take it off your hand.
Now, y'all,
she was like,
But y'all, my cool was hilarious, too, now. Y'all can get it. He knocked out the park.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He reminded me of the movie,
made the one that, but this year it went to Oscar. The other one did. Mm-hmm. That's what this movie reminds me of. If somebody was going to win the Oscar, it would be the villain. I call it the villain. It would be him because, wow.
But he is a villain, though.
Yeah, well, he was. It was Black Panther. He was the villain. You know, Black Panther won, but he had a point. When he said, you know, like when he killed so-called, he thought he killed Black Panther.
Right.
You know, he was, you know, that's over, that part over. Mm-hmm. When he saw Black Panther again, mm-hmm. most people would say, how could you? How did it happen? You again
no
or what?
More, man? No
he said, what's up? He said, what's up?
Actually, it was Killmonger, but it was one of his serious moments when he was dying. Mm-hmm. And he said, "Why? So you can just lock me up? No, just bury me in the ocean with my ancestors that jumped from the ships because they knew death was better than bondage." Mm-hmm. That's my favorite one. But then Killmonger, but M'Baku got me though. When he says, "Say one more word, I'm gonna feed you to my children." And he said, "No, I'm